Hello guys, welcome back to another Scrap 2 Unusual video. Today guys, this is episode 4 and we are doing some more unusual trading. Just to start off, I know it's been a while since the last video, but there's going to be no more of that. I'm going to be trying to do a Scrap 2 Unusual video every Wednesday and another video of my own choosing every Saturday on my channel. This doesn't really matter if I get no trades. I'll still do a video. It might be something like tips or whatever in trading. If I get loads and loads of trades, I won't have enough time to do tips. So I'll just be showing all the trades I've been doing in my Scrap 2 Unusual series. But yeah, also say what you guys want to see in my two videos a week, because that's pretty much what I'm gonna be aiming for right now. But enough talking. On with the video, and yeah, hope you guys enjoy it. Thanks for all the support. Bye. Alright, so on with the trading. As you guys could remember from the last video, we ended on 19 keys. So this means we could go into unusuals now, which are over 1 bud. The actual good ones, to be honest, compared to the ones we've been trading with so far before. So yeah, this is the first unusual I bought with those 19 keys. This is a Orbiting Fire Fruit Shoot, painted Australian gold. I really like this unusual. There's going to be a clip on later here showing it. Be in game with it. It's really, really, really cool. I really like this hat. It was a sniper hat, so it's not that bad. Orbiting Fire, second gen effect, so it's higher tier. And I think at the time it was worth 22 keys. So I bought it for 19. At the time, buds were around 19 keys, so I can't really talk in buds when I'm displaying these prices. I'm going to be talking in keys. But yeah. This was around 22 keys, so I was around 3 keys under. I thought I could set it for more, because it was really nice and unusual, so I bought it anyway. And yeah, it looks really, really cool. Really quick tip here on unusual trading, which you can see in the video right now. As you can see, I'm copying the URL from his Steam profile and putting it into Backpack. This means I can go to his backpack and I check the item. There's a thing in unusual trading called duped items. These are items which have been duplicated and they are worth less than normal items. You can check this by going onto their backpack, hovering over the item in their backpack, and then clicking on history. Then if there is a thing saying it's been duped, there's be a red box near the top of its history saying this item has been duped. If not, there will be no box there. Just make sure this when you're trading with someone, because if you do buy a duped item, it is worth a lot less. So always make sure you're buying pure, clean items, items that are not duped. And yeah, just a little tip there. Alrighty, so I had this fruit shoot for quite a long time, and for some reason I wasn't getting the offers I wanted on it, and I was getting a bit desperate because I'm really impatient in unusual trading, whereas normally unusual trades take an average of 2 weeks to actually trade it on, because unusuals are quite a big thing for people to trade with, and they need to like think about it and get a proper offer that both people are happy with. So it takes quite a while, but I was quite impatient. So I was on a trade server and I found this guy sending a Blissity Storm Birdcage. And I did it for a 1-for-1 with my fruit shoot. Looking back on this, it was not a very good idea, because Pyro Unusuals are rated around the same as Sniper. They are, you know, they're not great, but they're not bad. However, I couldn't sell this Blissity Storm Birdcage for the life of me. It took, I think, 4 weeks I had it up on offers and no one had given a single offer on it. It was really, really bad. I don't know if this is because of the hat and people don't like the hat, or Lizardy Storm, not a bad effect. Maybe on Pyro, because you know, no one wants to see a Pyro with a snowstorm over him, because that doesn't really make him seem like a dangerous fiery Pyro. I don't know, but I just did not get any offers on this. Really bad trade on my behalf. However, I managed to pull it off, as you'll see later. So the Blissity Storm Birdcage was worth around 22 keys, I think, on Backpack at the time. And, well, I was getting no offers on it. So I was giving offers on other people's outpost trades. I'd go into TF2 Outpost, look at all of the items or kind of unusuals, which I was really looking for. And looked at posts from people on unusuals that are around the same price as mine. And I'd make offers of my unusual for theirs on their trades. And I actually got one. I was able to give my birdcage plus a key in metal, which I'd actually got from just randomly playing the game. And also selling those limited summer crates that recently came out. I was able to sell them for a bit. And yeah, I was able to get it for this purple confetti bonk helm, which I loved. It was amazing. I was so happy to get it. It was rated on Backpack to be 19 keys, but never trust Backpack. Backpack normally has a lower or higher price than what the actual backpack or the actual price of your unusual is. Look on TF2 Outposts, see what people are getting offers on, and see what people are selling them for. See what kind of offers they're getting on the unusuals, and you're able to see what they are actually worth. And this one was worth a lot more, in fact. And yeah, I was able to get it for the birdcage. Even though it was worth less on Backpack, it was worth less in actual real value. So that was a good, really good trade on my behalf. I was able to put it off. I feel sorry for the guy who got the birdcage, but yeah, life goes on. Alright, so me being the impatient guy that I am, I really wanted to see what I could get for this unusual right off the bat. I was going onto people's trades and saying, hey, look, I got this really cool hat, and I was giving it to people. And me being a soldier, I'm a soldier in TF2, and I really love the soldier class, so I was looking for a soldier unusual that I could trade for my Bonk Helm. And just so happened someone else was having a purple confetti Stout Shaco, so I offered on him saying my Bonk Helm for your Stout Shaco. I don't know if I should have done this. I think I probably should have got more offers on my Bonk Helm before I did that. I think it was like one day and then I traded it. I like the Stout Shaco. It's really, really nice. The purple confetti look is really, really cool. And it's rated, I think, just a little bit more on Backpack. I think around 20 keys maybe. And it's around the same on an Outpost. People still like really, really like it. And people are selling it for around 1.3 to 1.5 buds. So that's quite cool. Recently I've been trying to sell it. I haven't got any offers on it, and I've been offering on people's so people don't really want it, but I'm sure I'll be able to get at least 24 or more keys on it. So I've been going up 5 keys since the 19 keys at the beginning, which means we are making time, we're making good progress. And I think I need to get around 30 keys to get to the unusual that I want. I might go on if people like the series so far, but I think all we need, if I'm able to sell this for 24 keys, 25 keys, is 5 or 6 more keys. So maybe one, maybe 2 more episodes, I don't know. It depends on how you guys enjoy it, and depends on pretty much my trading as well, and if I'm able to get the offers. But yeah, the unusual, as you see here, looks really, really, really nice. And yeah, I don't regret buying this at all. It was a really, really nice trade, and yeah, nice. Alright guys, but this does look like this is going to be the end of the video. But next video guys, what we're going to be trying to doing is sell this purple confetti Stout Shaco. Probably get some really cool unusuals next episode. Or if you guys want, I can give you guys some tips and stuff you want. Just say in the comments down below. If you guys have watched to the end, this point in the video, make sure you do write Steam is a piglet down in the comments below. I think if you have watched this far, I want to see who has, and just type in Steam is a piglet, like that. Just type it in the comments down below, and yeah, that'll make my day. But yeah, I hope you guys did enjoy the video. Again, this is going to be going on every Wednesday now, from now on, and another video every Saturday. Do say what kind of video you would like to see, apart from Sculptor Unusual, and of course, if you guys want to see Sculptor Unusual, let me know as well. Thank you everyone for adding me on Steam. I'll be sure to add you to the Steam group. And yeah, I think that's about everything. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.